say goodbye to trans fat, America. In a bold move, the FDA is telling food manufacturers they must remove all artificial trans fat from their products, saying it's not generally recognized as safe for use in human food. So, you know, your items like donuts, french fries, even your coffee creamer will have to change. CNN chief medical correspondent Dr. Sanjay Gupta joins me from Atlanta. Again, if I could just get a little trans fat 101 as we have this conversation, and to explain the announcement for me.
You love your trans fats, Brooke. I know you do.
Probably too much.
There are saturated fats. We think of those as the animal fats. And then there are unsaturated fats, more the vegetable oils. Saturated fats have long thought to be bad for you. And part of the thinking behind the saturated fats being bad for you sort of created these artificial trans fats. The industry said, look, okay, we won't use saturated fats anymore. We'll start to use these sort of partially saturated, if you will, fats. And those are the trans fats. They've been around for a long time. And it was interesting. It was sort of why people started using margarine, for example, instead of butter. I won't use the saturated fat stuff. I'll use the trans fat stuff. And we now know, and I think that that's in part what's been happening for some time now, we now know those trans fats probably worse than the fully saturated fats all along, that the margarine was probably worse than the butter all along, which is why coronary heart disease and heart attacks and all that have continued to go up in men and women for the last 30, 40 years. So this has been something that's been a long time coming.
So it's been a long time coming, but correct me, I mean, doesn't New York already have, you know, anti-trans fat laws and other countries do as well?
Yes, they do. In 2006, 2007, New York essentially banned these artificial trans fats. And other countries, Denmark, you know, being one of the big ones, did this as well back 12 years ago now. And so because it's been that long, you start to see, for example, in Denmark, some of the impact. You do start to see a decrease in people dying of heart disease. So, you know, it's not a direct cause and effect, but they're pretty confident that the trans fats have increased the likelihood of heart disease, and banning them, getting rid of them, will do the opposite.